We're back with tonight's line combination. Steve Bernier moves up to play with Andrei Loktionov and Ilya Kovalchuk, while the Eliash Zajac-Clarkson line stays the same. But how about this? Adam Henrique with Ryan Carter. And the new right wing, Matt D'Agostini. Sestito, Gionta, and Kostopoulos stay together. And Andy Green and Adam Larson were split up for about 10 minutes 2 games ago, but Pete DeBoer has had them back together the last couple of days. One other thing to look for, the Panthers have the worst first period goal differential in the league, a minus 18. Steven Chico will see if the Devils can take advantage of that tonight.
Thank you, Deb. He's been to the Stanley Cup playoffs twice in his career, 08-09 with the Canadiens and then last year with the Blues. So say hello, everyone, to the newest Devil, Matt D'Agostini. He's a right wing. The Devils insist as a guy you still label a goal scorer. And the hope is that he finds that form he displayed a couple of years ago when he put in 21 for the St. Louis Blues. Tonight's officials, Tim Repeal and Don Van Massenhoven, are the referees. Jean Moran, Derek Amel are the linesmen. Devils looking for back-to-back wins. Snapped the three-game losing streak 2 nights ago at Raleigh. They start with the line of Andrei Loktionov, Ilya Kovalchuk, and Steve Bernier is getting a look with this line to start things off tonight. The Panthers control in their own end. Puck winds around Marek Zielinski, throws one in front, and there's Bernier with the early redirection that's handled by Florida. Marcel Gotch had it taken away by Loktionov, and retreating back in his own zone is Zielinski for New Jersey. Paired with Bryce Salvador, here come the Devils as Bernier throws this into the Florida end. Met by Brian Campbell, Loktionov able to recover and send it in deep. Ilya Kovalchuk battles for the loose puck. It's picked up by the two-time Cup winner Thomas Kopetsky, and this is sent out to center. Adam Larson on for his first shift of the night. Long pass in the direction of Adam Henrique. Campbell is there. Handles this. No icing call here as the Panthers break out. Sean Mathias is number 18. Met at center ice and taken away. Here's Ryan Carter for the Devils. Trickling shot goes into the corner. Adam Henrique dumps it in deeper. Here's D'Agostini. He's wearing number 16. Devils throw this back to the point, but it gets all the way back into their own end. Martin Brodeur, second consecutive start after a 13-game absence.
Got a nice ovation, didn't he, Steve, when they introduced him? People rose on their feet and gave him a heck of a hand.
Well, you called it. It was really a legendary game by him the other night.
You're right, so let's go to the goaltender. So tonight's goaltending matchups are presented by SportJapper, the free app for talking about tonight's game. Get it now on SportJapper.com. They used to be teammates. Now they're trying to beat each other. There you see the career stats Scott Clemenson has against the Devils. And Marty Brodeur, how about that? A couple goals, all those assists. I don't think we'll see him on the power play tonight, even though he scored a power play goal the last time. But he could help with an assist, firing it up on a breakout.
Said there were more messages after being credited with the goal than any 50-save performance he might have had over the years for New Jersey. David Clarkson, Travis Zajac, Patrick Eliash. This line remains intact after the victory over Carolina, and why not? They were good 2 nights ago. Salvador back to collect this. The Devils captain controls. Pass to center is picked up here by Clarkson. David Clarkson. Walks through the neutral zone, but it's stripped away. Quinton Howden with the early shot that goes wide of Brodeur's game. Picked up by Salvador, who starts the rush the other way. At center ice, number 13, Mike Santorelli for Florida. Written off on the play by Tim Sestito. Here's Peter Harold with the puck for New Jersey, and it's played in deep. Crushing hit by Sestito on number 23, Tyson Strachan of Florida. Clearing attempt blocked away by Sestito, and now Kostopoulos giving chase. Strachan moves it ahead to center and picked up at center ice by Florida, and Jared Smithson dumps it in. Opening moments here at the Rock. Harold, the pass from Volchenkov, now sends it into the Florida zone. Back to give chase is TJ Brennan, and it's icing against New Jersey.
Well, boy, every team wants to score first. And really, how important is it? Well, the Devils are 11-1-2, and that's the best, fifth best point percentage in the National Hockey League, Steve. So it just shows you what it does to the team psyche when you score that first goal. They did it in Carolina and built three more off of it, and they're hoping to do that tonight.
Well, that was the other plus about the Brodeur goal the other night, and there were so many of them. That marked just the third time in 15 games that the Devils took the lead off the draw. Quick shot by Huberdeau is blocked away in front. He wears number 11, first-year Florida Panther, and what many believe will be a rising star in the NHL in the next few seasons. Puck comes out to center. Steven Gionta battling along the near boards, plays it ahead, and here's Bernier picking up the loose puck. Tried the little toe drag, and Brennan able to defend that. Colby Roback, number 47, Florida defenseman, plays it ahead. Kopetsky with a shot off a Devil's stick for a stoppage in play.
Well, I don't think Kevin Denis saw this season coming, Steve, after what they did in the playoffs, but injuries has really taken its toll. But right now, they have two straight wins, but they've given up a lot of shots, 78 shots allowed against their goalies, and they've never won three in a row this year. So this is a high watermark for them, even at two. But so far, they played well. This game started slow, and of course, the Devils, I think, are going to have to manufacture the energy to say, this is a game we cannot lose. There's no ifs, ands, or buts, and the best way to do that is to get started the right way, get a goal, a two lead, and go from there.
Panthers have the lowest point total in the National Hockey League, 24. Bernier centering try, and Loktionov looking to finish. No can do. Taken away here by Florida. Marcel Gotch deep into the zone. Sends one wide of Brodeur's cage. Dmitry Kulikov, number 7, back in the Florida lineup after a 9-game absence. Their talented young defenseman, Eric Gudbranson, missing tonight because of the flu. Clemenson gives here to Philip Kuba. At center ice, Thomas Fleischmann plays it across. Sean Mathias gets back onside. Big hit by Volchenkov, delivering that on Jack Skilly. Back to the point, Campbell sends it in deep. Peter Harold in the direction of Clarkson. That try from the near side goes wide. Off the stick of Scotty Upshaw. Deep in the zone, Harold with Skilly giving chase. Here's Upshaw trying to play the puck off the backboard. Comes in front, but Volchenkov's got it. Gives to Eliash. Ferocious forecheck by Florida, works the puck free. Mathias battling for it, and Zajac lifts it away. Campbell plays it across. Santarelli, pass out of the zone. Upshaw trying to control, battling with Adam Henry. And sent into the Devil's zone. Been an uphill climb for the Panthers. So many devastating injuries cutting into their season. After winning the division for the first time ever last season. Santarelli, pounded by Zdlitsky, but keeps on going. Loose puck in the corner. Howden delivers a check. Santarelli still on the puck. Takes a hit from Ryan Carter in the corner. Santarelli still able to control with a slew of Devils around him. Now it's poked towards the point and played back. And a shot by Roback goes wide. Good pressure by the Panthers as Zdlitsky is able to get it out of the zone. Racing forward, Ryan Carter wins the battle for the loose puck. Now checked in the boards by Roback, but the reinforcements are coming. Smithson able to play it across, and he picks up Howden. Winton Howden on the move. Plays it in deep. Brodeur swats it away. Larson under some pressure. Now Peter Mueller battling for the loose puck deep in the Devils' zone. Huberdeau able to control. Centering try, but taken away by Larson. Tom Kostopoulos plays it back for Larson. Panthers are in the midst of a 5-game road trip. They've won the first two. Many believe this is the only team in the East out of the playoff race, but if they win out on this road trip, who knows? Here's Larson.
Real crazy start to this game. It's quiet in the building. Not much of anything has happened. You just wait for something, a big hit, good offensive chance.
With bated breath for Larson to get that puck out from behind the net. Taken back and played here by Tyson Strachan for Florida. Things figure to heat up here tonight. This is a big game for New Jersey. Kopetsky over the line. Plays it across, pass in the direction of Gotch, and Fleischmann goes all the way to Kovalchuk. Able to chop it out of the zone. No, Campbell is able to keep the puck alive. Gotch winds it around. Plays this for Kopetsky. Fleischmann, centering try, Kopetsky with a shot, Brodeur with the save through traffic, and there was Gotch at the doorstep. Another centering try, and the loose puck picked up here by Bernier. Dishes across. Loktionov over the Florida line. Kovalchuk heading for the net. Loktionov crosses with Kovalchuk, and everybody collides and goes down. Except for Kobe to the bench. Shot by Salvador, and that's blocked away. Bouncing puck picked up here by Zidlitsky. 7.5 in, no score. Here's Clevenson. Nearly had it taken away by the onrushing Eliash. Strachan, under pressure from Zajac. He's smoked out and banks it away. Ryan Campbell controls for Florida. Gets it out of the zone, but that's about as far as it got. And Strachan takes this for the Panthers. Long pass across. Played back for Brian Campbell. He was an NHL All-Star last year, number 51. Mathias on the move for the Panthers. Darts into the devil's zone. Here's Upshaw. Throws one in deep. Loose behind the cage and comes out here to Carter. Cross-eyes pass. D'Agostini, nice job to control off the skate. Sends it in deep. Given away by Clevenson. D'Agostini, centering try, but blocked away by Kuba. At the point, Andy Green sends one towards goal, just wide of Clevenson's cage. Adam Larson pushes it into the corner. D'Agostini, good give. Ryan Carter tries to throw one in front. Bouncing puck comes out to center.
D'Agostini showing some of that speed he's known for. Good job of board checking there. Put pressure on the Panthers early.
Nice move by Carter. Gives to Henrik. Back to the point. Volchenkov, and a shot blocked away. Good surge by the Devils. Been a while since we've had a stoppage in play, and taken here behind the cage by Anton Volchenkov.
Interesting breakout. Three Devils were heading to center ice, and then Stephen Johnson said, oh, I'm the centerman here. I better go back.
Levinson gets it away from the onrushing Kostopoulos. Picked up. Howden pushes this into the Devils zone. Peter Harrell back to give chase. Nice job to deny him. Bouncing puck. Renan trying to get that for Florida, and the puck goes out to center. Colby Roback, the 22-year-old defenseman, into the Devils zone. Picked up here by Santarelli. His shot blocked away by Salvador. Behind the cage, Peter Harrell collects here for New Jersey. Dumps it away. Harrell's been good lately. Points in each of his last three games. Here comes Loktionov for the Devils. Quick shot, blocked away off Roback, and into the netting for a stoppage in play. No score, middle of the first period.
Not much for offense so far, but keep riding that skate there. Bernier's trying to throw it to the front of the net. Scotty Clements and the goalie was telling me a lot of these have happened this year, many of them ending up in the net. I said I've never seen so many pucks hit my own man and go in the net. Now there, Peter Harrell, what a job of blocking out Gotch. And then he's the one who got that shot and put it into the corner. He's on a bit of an offensive tear, Steve, but to stay in the lineup, it's those kinds of plays that will keep him there, and there'll be no argument. And then when he puts in the offensive points, that's just a big bonus.
How about on Visa Devils game night, Grant Marshall joining us tonight. He is a big Peter Harrell advocate, as he let Deb Placey know in the pregame show.
Well, you know, I think Grant Marshall can identify with guys that have to really work hard to get a spot in the lineup and to be prominent, which Grant became.
Taken here by Kovalchuk. Pass from Loktionov. Went off his stick. Zidlitsky gets rid of this. Going for the midair redirection was Loktionov. And taken here by Kovalchuk. Tried the turnaround shot and didn't get a lot of it. Another try for Kovalchuk. Big shot. Deflected up and out of play.
He was like a golfer. He was just warming up on the first one. And then he ripped that last one. Well, here, this is a spinorama. That Kobe says, whoops. Okay, now I got my upper body all warmed up here, and then this one here, did that thing fly? Fortunately for Clemenson, it went over the netting. I don't know if it hit something or not.
Kobe's not the shy retiring type if the first one doesn't go. Taken back here by Florida. Better than halfway through the period, the Panthers still looking for their first shot on goal. And will they get it here? No, that shot by Drew Shore fired wide of the cage. Kulikov pinching in for the Panthers, able to play it in deep. Larson and Green, Devils defense pairing, each battling deep in the zone. Travis Zajac there as well, able to work the puck free, but it comes back to Kuba towards the point, and that shot deflected away. Picked up behind the cage by Andy Green. Headband pass, Clarkson gives to Travis Zajac. Room for Zajac down the right side. Able to walk in. Darts behind the cage. Works it back to the point. Volchenkov gives to Harrell. Back to Volchenkov at the point. His shot. Reviser deflected away. Wide of the cage. Harrell again keeps the puck free and it bounces out to center. Drew Shore trying to get on this. Gives to Huberdeau. Jonathan Huberdeau. A little spinorama. Backhand try. Went wide of the cage.
Well, Shore doesn't know the moves this kid has. If he had turned and went backwards, he would have got a return pass on a no-look behind the backer from Huberdeau.
Roback takes this for Florida. So many injuries the Panthers are dealing with. One of them to their captain and defenseman, Ed Jovanovski. Giving a chance for the likes of Roback to join the lineup. Here's Ryan Carter down the right side for the Devils. Knocked down on the play by Brennan. Puck jarred loose. Brennan able to get a glove on it. Devils still fighting for it. It's jarred loose by Carter. Behind the cage, taken here by Roback, and he gives to Scotty Upshaw. Pass across for Sean Mathias, who fires into the Devils' zone. Puck winds around, battling for it in the corner. D'Agostini in his Devils' debut. Carter able to work the puck free, but it deflects into the Devils' bench. And we'll step aside again with 7:43 to go in the opening period.
Back at the Rock, where the game is still scoreless, stay with us for the Delta Intermission Report. We'll chat with the newest Devil, Matt D'Agostini, and find out what the last 24 hours has been like for him. That's all coming up on the Delta Intermission Report right after the first period, guys.
And the Maven is with us. He'll be part of it all tonight on this Saturday night. First meeting between the teams since April 26, 2012. Game 7 of the Eastern Conference quarterfinals nearly 11 months ago. And as Deb told you, three times they'll play each other over the final 17 games this season. Devils will be at Sunrise 1 week from tonight for round two. And off the draw, Bryce Salvador tries to play it out of the zone. Now the Devils captain on a second try. Gives to Henrique and the pass ahead for Ryan Carter. A juggling of Pete DeBoer's lines tonight with the new addition, D'Agostini, in the fold. Brian Campbell plays this to center. Worked across. Here's the German-born center. Marcel Gotch plays it in deep. Salvador deep in his own end. Fleischman was there, but it's worked free. Ryan Carter under a pretty good forecheck, and it goes to the opposite side where Zidlitsky takes for New Jersey. Salvador gets it away from Kopetsky. Gotch in the corner for Florida. Bouncing puck controlled by Bryce Salvador. Able to pick up Clarkson at center ice, and he dumps in. Back to give chase is Strachan, and a whistle on the play. We talked about the devastating injuries for the Florida Panthers. How do you overcome this? The top two, Steven Weiss, Christopher Stieg, out for the season. Wrist surgery and knee surgery. Then Jose Theodore, the goaltender. Ed Jovanovski, their captain, Mike Weaver on defense. Sean Bergenheim, George Parros has been out the last couple of games. Look at a guy like Fleischman. You took away his two line mates, a dynamite line last year, and it tells you where the team is right now.
Yeah, you know, and Weiss, Theodore, Jovanovski, will they come back? You know, there's going to be a wholesale change. They're in the midst of it now, Steve. There's a lot of faces that are out on the ice tonight for the Panthers that weren't there last spring.
Felt like Steven Weiss played his final game for the organization when he got hurt. That remains to be seen. Jovanovski could be moved in a trade. He still has 2 years remaining on his contract. Taken here by Florida. Worked out to center and Upshaw. Steers it back towards the Devils' end. Taken here by Andy Green. Adam Larson to center. Elias had it knocked off his stick and taken here by Larson again. Into the Panthers' zone. Dmitry Kulikov. Took a hit from Elliott. Loose puck. Battling for it. Travis Zajac in the corner. Trying to get away from Mathias and does. Puck kept in at the point by Andy Green. Elias for the redirection and that wouldn't go. Picked up by Mathias who darts back the other way. Here's Upshaw into the Devil's end. Met by Larson. Laid off the boards for David Clarkson. Foot race back into the Devil's zone. Campbell makes the touch and it's icing.
Well, Christopher Stieg is greatly missed here, and there you see number 32 getting clipped. He could see the danger coming, couldn't jump out of the way of this, and look at his right hip. It is just drilled, and he went down, and that was a real unfortunate injury for them, Steve. He's their offensive go-to guy.
So good against the Devils last year, regular season and playoffs, was Christopher Stieg. Nice job by Andy Green to maneuver out of traffic and play this to center, where Clarkson takes for New Jersey and dumps in. Strachan back to collect for the Panthers. Winds it around to the stick of Brian Campbell. His pass taken away by Kovalchuk. Offside was Bernier. Kovalchuk had to back up, and the Panthers take it away. Laid across, Strachan for Florida. 23-year-old defenseman plays it across. Here's Shore over the Devils' line. Got around Lakhdianov and sealed off by Zidlitsky. Steve Bernier in the Devils' zone. Across, Marek Zidlitsky for Lakhdianov. Now the Devils on the move. Here's Marek Zidlitsky over the line. Tries to throw one towards goal. Blocked away by Roback. Coming out of the corner with it is the long-haired Peter Mueller. Sent into the Devils' zone. Howden. Bumps with Cespita. Salvador fighting for the loose puck. It's behind Brodeur's cage. Yard into the corner. First man to it is Tim Cespita. Shovels it ahead. Kovalchuk there. Puck still being fought for along the near boards and sent in off Brodeur's glove by Roback.
Three shots by both teams up to this point.
4:20 left in the first period. Bouncing puck for Brennan. Look out. Kostopoulos nearly had a chance and taken here by the Panthers. Santarelli took a hit from Volchenko. That was one of the unsung heroes in that turning point game the other night. Volchenko was very good defensively. Blocked shots on the way he hit against the Hurricanes. On the puck now is Anton. Sends it into the Florida zone. Clemenson behind his net. Winds it around. Gotch. Able to send it ahead to the stick of Fleischman. Able to pick up Kopetsky over the Devils' line. Thomas Kopetsky gets it past Brodeur. Centering try. Goes all the way back to the point, and Kulikov picks this up for the Panthers. Soft shot off a skate in front and pushed ahead to Ryan Carter's stick. Here's the Russian-born Dmitry Kulikov across for Philip Kuba. Played ahead, Kopetsky steers it into the Devils' end where it's picked up by Adam Larson. 3:20 left, first period. D'Agostini for New Jersey. Here's Andy Green. Gives to Larson. Fires into the Panthers' zone. TJ Brennan. Under pressure from D'Agostini. Nice job to avoid him. And Florida breaks out. Here's Mathias dishing it off. Scotty Upshaw sends one towards goal. Over Brodeur's cage and picked up here by Zajac. Pushes it ahead. Eliash played it across. Devils in the midst of a change, though, and here's Brennan the other way. Taken off his stick by Larson. Taken away by Upshaw. Dishes it across. Brennan got a shot away, and that one went wide. Eliash at center. Throws it ahead, trying to get it to an on-rushing David Clarkson, but that's broken up.
Devils coaches are not liking what they are seeing here, Steve. You know, the Panthers give up a lot of shots. But you got to have the puck to do that. Devils do not have much puck possession tonight.
Nearly taken away at the point. Now Clarkson deflects it out to center.
I mean, the Rangers threw like 78 shots at the Panthers' goal the other night. It's because they controlled the biscuit so long. But right now, it's been the Panthers on the rush, on the forecheck, on the battle for pucks.
Kopetsky threw one in front, and Brodeur able to make the stop. It was Jacob Markstrom who's the star of that show in a 44-save performance at Madison Square Garden in their last game on the trip. He's getting the night off, likely to start tomorrow night against the Islanders. At the point, Strachan plays this. Taken away, Bernier battling for it along the far boards as it goes behind the Devils' net. Picked up here by Volchenko. Kovalchuk couldn't get it out of the zone. Kept alive. Huberto plays it back. Here's Brian Campbell with a shot saved by Brodeur, and he quickly covers up. Minute and a half remaining in the opening period. No score and just five shots total. Martin Brodeur back in goal tonight. Believe it or not, there are some NHL records Martin Brodeur does not hold. But he's giving chase to this one. The goal in the game against Carolina was his 43rd career point just in the regular season. And that still trails Tom Barrazzo by 48. The rest on that list, Grant Fuhr, Patrick Roy, and then Brodeur. Any of those three handle the puck nearly as well as Marty in their careers?
Tom Barrasso was very good. As a 19-year-old even, he could do it. Grant Fuhrer was a bit more of an adventure, but Patrick Roy, I think playing with some of the players that he did, and not that he was bad, but you're giving it off to Sakic, you're giving it off to Forsberg, you're going to get a lot of assists. But one thing we do know about Marty, I'll get to it in a minute, he is the goal leader now among goalies. He passed Ronnie Hextall in overall goals, regular season and playoffs with his third.
Montreal, the playoff goal where Brodeur actually shot the puck in. We've done a lot of reminiscing, and so has he over the last couple of days. As Zajac sends this into the Panthers' end, and it's picked up here by Kulikov. Devils have gone better than 15 minutes without a shot on goal now, as Fleischman plays it across, and a big drive from the far side. Off the stick of Gotch went wide. It's picked up here by Kopetsky. Plays it back to the point. Here's Kulikov with a shot. Saved by Brodeur. He juggled, but he's got it.
That's beautiful. Marty just flowed off the post. But the Devils' forechecking has been almost non-existent. And then in their own end, the Panthers are finding some seams here. And Kulikov, just back off being injured, has a big shot. He's point man on the power play, but Marty Brodeur is able to get a real good look at that. Bobbled it a little bit, but in the end did all he had to do.
45 seconds to go, opening period. Here's Campbell throwing it in deep. Mueller tied up with Zydlewski. Puck loose with Huberdeau, dangerously sitting in front of the net, but Carter gets it out to center, and it's picked up here by Adam Henrique. Two on one, gets it back from Kovalchuk. Henrique tried to go backhand and never got the shot away.
Strachan, what a play by Strachan. Cash, he was a back-checking defenseman. Otherwise, it'd be 1-0 right now. The goal by Henrique.
Mueller's soft shot steered away by Brodeur. Kopetsky battling deep in the devil zone. Kopetsky able to take it away. Bouncing puck, sure. Tried to get a shot away, and it's blocked. Behind the net, Mueller with a centering try. Final seconds of the period as Salvador skates it away, and period one comes to an end.
Not many mistakes in that first period by either team, but Strachan saves his team a goal. Now watch here. It's going to bounce up. And he's the guy in the middle of your screen. He continues on, and he makes the smart back check. He doesn't go to his right. He stays over here with Henrique. And as Adam tries to take it to his backhand, Strachan chops down on his stick. And Henrique isn't able to turn the wrist and put it in the open cage. And that was definitely, Steve, the play of the first period.
And with that said, the Devils Army is growing stronger every day. A terrific crowd again tonight. Over the past two seasons, over 4,700 new season ticket holders pledged loyalty to Jersey's team. Now secure the best full season seat locations still available with 2013-2014 early access. Sign on now to enjoy Stanley Cup playoff priority, exclusive season ticket holder benefits, along with other great perks. Call 1-800-NJ-DEVIL or visit NewJerseyDevils.com/early to get your jersey on. Tonight after the game, Pito, Jaffe, Danico, Maloney, complete post-game analysis of the game you're watching and a trip around the National Hockey League. It's Hockey Night Live presented by Kia. The boys will preview Rangers, Caps, Islanders, Flyers tomorrow. Stan Fischler's list of top five NHL defensemen. I suggested Duncan Keith. He said no. So watch with interest following tonight's game and see what the Maven serves up. Right after things at Prudential Center on MSG+. Second period set to begin.
How about Brian Campbell? It's a possibility. I know we don't know, but he's playing in tonight's hockey game, and that man there, the only two shots on goal in that first period. One, he actually tried to pass it and hit a Panther skate and went on goal, so we can't really classify that as trying to shoot on goal. But the Devils, I mean, from start to finish, every department, they just got to be better. You don't want to let the Panthers hang around, Steve. You don't. It's a team that doesn't come back well. You want to get a goal or two here in the second and give yourself a little cushion if you're the Devils.
Well, that's the lowest shot output of any period the Devils have played so far this season. Have to go back to February of last year to find the last time against the Rangers as Kovalchuk sends one across and Zydlewski drops it back where Loktyanov plays it in deep. Salvador battling along the near boards, but work free. Ryan Campbell plays it ahead, and here's Marcel Gotch for Florida dumping in. Now there's Fleischman in the corner. Centering try, looking to pick up Kopetsky. Cutting in front, Zydlewski takes the puck for New Jersey and dumps it away. Kulikov back to chase for Florida. It's an early icing against New Jersey.
Talked with Scotty last night for about an hour and just said, Scotty, you know, what's your best memories of being here in New Jersey? There was a stretch there, you see it, in 08-09 when Marty unfortunately got hurt. But he said, that was the best time of my life. He said, we had a great room, we were winning, I knew I was playing all the time, I'd get in a rhythm and the fans were into it.
Played back to the point, Brodeur missed 50 games that year for New Jersey. Came back and later on that season set the all-time wins record, surpassing Patrick Waugh, but Clemenson got them through much of the dog days of winter that season. New Jersey division champions fell to Carolina in the opening round of the playoffs that year. Kovalchuk knocked down at his own end and taken away by New Jersey. Picked up at center. Zajac sends one across. They score! Into the backboard, but out of nowhere gives the Devils the 1-0 lead.
What a goal, what a goal. And a nice deflection now. Puck's gonna go along here. You see Zajac with it. Head up, he throws it to the middle. And Clemenson thinks it's gonna go to his right pad. Instead, Eliash deeks in and just pushes it through the legs. Kulikov gets caught. Number 7. There you see his turn. You know, he hasn't played. There was a little rust on that pivot by Kulikov, and Elias made him pay as he deflected it through Clemenson's legs for his 10th goal of the year, his 29th point. He continues to lead the Devils.
He becomes fourth member of the double-digit goal club in New Jersey. And sent back in by Volchenkov. The Eliash goal on just the Devils' third shot on goal tonight. And the points now starting to come for Travis Zajac. He has points in three consecutive games with the primary assist on that. Scotty Upshaw plays this behind the Devils' goal. Peter Harold able to get this ahead. And it comes to the skate of Ryan Carter. Fires into the Panthers zone, steered away by Clemenson. TJ Brennan plays it ahead for Skilling. Sean Mathias into the Devils' end. Andy Green is back to give chase. Zajac, the lone assist at 1:24, the second period. Here's D'Agostini in his Devils' debut. Quick shot, that's blocked away by Clemenson. Smithson battling for it. Puck came to D'Agostini, but he fired that puck wide. Under pressure, the Panthers are. Kostopoulos on the forecheck. Taken here by Santarelli, who plays it in deep into the Devils' zone. Brodeur to the stick of Andy Green. D'Agostini sends it the length of the ice, but it's on goal, and Clemenson has to play. Gets rid of it quickly to the stick of Tyson Strachan. And pounded right back in by D'Agostini. Devils use this time to make the change. And Campbell sends this out of play.
Kulikov, number 7 for the Panthers, missed 10 games through injury. And there, I don't know where he was going, but he gets caught. Obviously, Eliash is his man here. And he was going forward when everybody was going the other way. And a beautiful deflection there by Patrick. And it's not the first time he's put a puck by a Panther goalie. There you see his stats against the Florida Panthers. I remember way back early in his career, he scored some big goals, some overtime goals against the Panthers. So it's nothing new for Patrick.
Career goal number 371, the Devils' all-time leader in that department. Loose behind the Devils' cage. Lakianov trying to keep up with Marcel Gotch. Darting back and forth. Now Kulikov at the point. Under pressure from Henrique. Puck taken away, and Lakianov pushes this out to center. Henrique trying to gobble it up, but taken back by the Panthers. And Kulikov, eye shot on Brodeur, but the play was offside anyway.
Well, Scotty Clemenson knows his role on this team. He's going to be 36 by the time next season rolls around, and he's going to be a great mentor for this guy here. That's Jacob Markstrom. High upside, Steve. You know, you talked about Huberdeau not bringing him up too early last year. They've done the same thing with him as a goaltender. Yeah, he maybe could have played before this, had more of a role, but they've kept him in the minor leagues to hone his skills, and he has proven on this trip that he's ready to take the ball and run with it here with the Panthers.
Hails from Sweden and beat one of his home country heroes the other night at the Garden in Henrik Lundqvist. Just 8 NHL games prior to this year. Zajac, a 2-on-1 with Clarkson, and that deflected off the skate of Brian Campbell. Zajac still trying to win the puck battle along the far boards, taken away by Florida, and played across to the stick of Jack Skilly. Knocked off a stick, and back the other way come the Devils. Here's Eliash. Sends one in front, looking for Gianta. The redirection wouldn't go. Steven Gianta works it back to the point. Covering there, Peter Harrell sends it right back in deep. Harrell at the point, battling with Huberdeau. Peter Harrell backhand tries to shovel it in front for Clarkson, but the pass never got there. Devils now have found a little bit of a groove since the goal by Eliash. Striking for Campbell. Huberdeau's pass across. He picks up Peter Mueller over the Devils' line, heading for the net ashore. Here's Huberdeau, backhand try, big stop by Brodeur.
Just a great read by Marty Brodeur. There was a lot of things flashing in front of him, but he knew what he wanted to do and did it.
Here's Bernier for the Devils, darting in, poked off his stick by Colby Roback. And now the Marty chance start up at Prudential Center. Wraparound try by Bernier is stopped. Comes back to the point where Salvador's got it. Plays it across, Zidlitsky fires, and a shot went wide. Came off the backboard, and trying to hammer it home was Tim Cestito. Brennan takes a hit from Cestito. Bernier trying to get on the loose puck. Behind the net, Kostopoulos battling for this. Works it away from Roback. And the Devils have the Panthers pinned in a bit here in this stretch in period two. Now Brennan trying to work it free, and it comes down where D'Agostini will collect. Lays it across, picks up Cestito. He's over the Florida line, run off by Santorelli. Clemenson gets rid of it quickly. Roback works it ahead, now Santorelli across for Kulikov. Panthers trying to stay perfect on this five-game road trip. Getting the first two against Carolina and the New York Rangers. Volchenkov just avoided a big hit by Smithson. Clemenson works it across, comes to the stick of Philip Kuba. Outlet pass, here's Santorelli on the move for Florida. Over the Devils' line, fires it in, Harrell in the corner. Works the puck free. Kovalchuk tried to play it. Instead, bouncing puck, Santorelli played it in the direction of Harrell. Peter Harrell fires into the Panthers' zone. Henrique reverses course. Harrell picks it up along the board. Centering try deflects all the way to the stick of Thomas Kopetsky. Kopetsky over the Devils' line. Andy Green is back. His shot blocked away by Green. Loose puck taken by Fleischman. That pass goes all the way to Kopetsky. Takes a bump from Green. This enables Harrell to take the puck. Tries to deflect it out of the zone and does. Fleischman chops it away from Kovalchuk. Loose puck taken here by Zajac, who dumps in. Eliash quickly to Clarkson, and a shot saved by Clemenson. And taken by Fleischman. Kopetsky over the line. Rose it in the direction of Fleischman, just out of his reach. And it comes back to Adam Larson. Andy Green for the Devils. Funnels one ahead, gloved down by Tyson Strachan and sent back. 7.5 minutes through period two. It's icing against Florida.
The youngster, Huberdeau, he gets this puck. And see, there's Marty can't really see much, but he said he's not going low through the legs. Huberdeau really does a nice job there of coming late and getting free. And at the other end, you're going to see Clemenson here as the Devils attack three men. And Matt D'Agostini was talking about a bitter forecheck, more puck possession. That's what you're seeing from the Devils.
Quinton Howden ridden off by Zidlitsky. Salvador able to take the puck. Headman pass to Ryan Carter. Left the puck behind him. Our first penalty of the game is coming up, and it's against the Devils. It's a trip. Marek Zidlitsky to the
first penalty of the game has just occurred. Jack's Skilly gets his puck. He almost gets skewered there by Zedlitsky. Referees love those cans. It's just a no-brainer. They just call it, and everybody knows the issues. And now the Panthers on the power play. They've been outshot 6-1 here in this second period. Have a chance to regain some momentum.
Recently had an 0-for-18 drought. This is not a bad power play. It's middle of the pack in the NHL, ranked 15th overall. Gotch will take the faceoff against Adam Henrique.
And remember, they've scored 3 goals in their last 2 games on their power play, which has helped that win column.
Henrique wins the draw, and that starts the penalty kill for the Devils. Henrique, Kovalchuk, forward tandem on the penalty kill. Volchenkov and Salvador, the defense pairing. This is Gotch over the line, gives to Kopetsky, and shovels it ahead. Work back, Gotch to the point, bouncing puck, Filip Kuba can't control. Kovalchuk trying to work it free, and he does. Ilya Kovalchuk able to walk in, shoots, and Clemenson got it with the glove.
Oh, and you know, Kovalchuk thinks he got slashed on that. We'll take a look at it. He doesn't argue very often, but in that one, he's looking at all the officials. Come on, somebody must have seen it, he's saying.
Kovalchuk leads the NHL in shorthanded goals. The Devils do as a team as well with 8. In the corner, Fleischman able to work this in front. Kopetsky back to the point. That's too hot to handle for Kuba, who has to retreat. Picked up at center by Gotch. Played in the direction of Kopetsky. Got by him, Salvador. First man of the loose puck. Reverses course. Zajac under pressure from Gotch. Tries to wind it around the boards and does. Hit Kopetsky in the skate. Devils are arguing too many men on the ice call. Florida, though, plays on. There is no whistle. Kulikov takes this. Power play continues. Drop back to the point. Fleischman gives to Campbell. Here's Huberto. Jonathan Huberto shovels it back to the point. Shot by Campbell, and it goes wide of Brodeur's cage. Picked up again by the teenage wonder Huberto in the corner. Muscled away by Salvador, and the puck sent back into the Florida end. 17 seconds to go, and the Florida man advantage. Here's Huberto sending it in deep. Mueller centering try. Huberto shot. It would not go. Brodeur might have gotten a piece of it.
Oh, he got a big piece of it, Steve.
Played by Kulikov. Giunta knocked down in front. TJ Brennan. Pass deflects off his stick. Behind the net. Huberto again looking at his options. Kulikov a shot.
Oh, no.
Off his own teammate, Mathias. And now the whistle. And everybody's eyes point to the injured Sean Mathias.
Well, it came up in his face. And we'll see what the results are. Let's hope nothing serious. Boy, there's been a rash of these recently. You know, Ilya Kovalchuk was not pleased, and I think here's the situation here. He can't find it. I guess he thinks a little bit of an interference call, and then he shoots and Clemenson with a good glove save. But apparently it was that play there that Ilya was upset about, and a nice snapper save, and another injury to this injury torn apart team, the Florida Panthers. Now here is Huberto. He gets banged into Brodeur. He's been stopped by Marty a couple. Oh, I like that, Marty. You see, Marty got up and just gave the rookie a little slash. Marty may have heard that Huberto's favorite team. And oh, there's the one, unfortunately, it came up. Watch number 18 to your left here. Boy, the forwards in front of the net, Steve, depends so much on the guys at the point shooting the puck low.
Important player in the scheme of things now for Florida is Mathias. Kostopoulos with a shot out of nowhere, and Clemenson covers up as it goes off the backboard. Successful penalty kill for the Devils. They lead 1-0.
There's nothing more exciting than celebrating the birth of a child, and we want to give a big congratulations to Paul and Rebecca Zecca on their baby boy, Blaze Carmen Zecca. And look at those eyes. Now his papa is a goalie. Look at the focus on Blaze already. I mean, that's a great sports name, Blaze. Paulie, if you came up with that, I'm giving you a high five when I see you in the truck next home game. But that's a great, great time for them, I'm sure.
I saw the teal and orange colors in the baby crib, and I'm wondering if a certain Dolphins fan in our truck might have doctored the picture. More on that later. Let's watch the face-off as Santarelli cannot get it back. Instead, taken by the Devils, and a quick shot by Sestito is blocked away and out of play. Faceoff will stay in the Florida zone.
Well, here's where the Devils, this juncture of the game is where the Devils have a chance to really grab control of this game and make it so no bad breaks down the stretch or even a flurry by the Panthers will just derail what should be a victory. I mean, let's be honest. Devils are hungry for a victory. They're coming off one. They're much deeper. They're just a better team right now. Panthers may be the team of the future, Steve. We'll get to that later. But boy, are they in good shape when it comes to young players and prospects that are either in college or junior hockey.
Played back here by Harrell. Picked up at center ice by Travis Zajac. Over the line, sends it in. Eliash collects, sends it across, and that pass just behind David Clarkson and banked out to center. Devils out shooting the Panthers 6-2 here in the second period. Howden takes this for Florida, works it back where Kulikov is able to play it across. Philip Kuba sends it into the corner, picked up here by Howden. Worked back to the point, Kulikov, long range shot, goes way wide of the cage. And taken by Clarkson. Sent out to center, Eliash trying to get to the loose puck. Kulikov deflected it away, taken here by Zajac. He gives to Clarkson, quick shot, saved by Clemenson. The puck's still loose, they score! David Clarkson never quit on the play. Will it count?
Yes, it will. Now, this is a David Clarkson-type goal, his 12th of the year. And he's got the shovel out on the rebound. He just will not be denied on this. Clarkson stops it. Clemenson thinks he's got it. And I wonder if Clemenson doesn't come down on the top of his stick with his glove. Watch here. See his glove is on the top of the stick, so the glove doesn't hit the ice or the puck. And the puck's underneath there. Here you'll get a good look at it. And David, he doesn't just jam at it, Steve. He stops. And coaches will tell you, when you drive the net, don't just curl by. Don't let your momentum take it beyond the goal line. David just waited and waited. When it was loose, he ripped her home for his 11th of the season. 12th.
And that is the team lead. David Clarkson icing against New Jersey as Campbell makes the touch.
Okay. Here we're going to see it again. I think that was that Zajac got chopped. So watch the glove of Clemenson. You see there, it's on top of his stick, and his stick is on its edge rather than flat. I know it's a little thing, Steve, but otherwise he covers it.
Campbell shot. Shank wide of the goal and taken here by Gotch. Works it back to the point, striking with a drive, saved by Brodeur, and swept away to the stick of Lukyanov.
Well, Travis Zajac took a real big chop on that, Steve. He looked like he was injured, but another assist for Travis, which is good news for he and the Devils.
Back-to-back two-point games for Travis Zajac as Henrik plays this for Kovalchuk. At the blue line, now sends it in deep. Henrik sealed off by Strachan. Puck taken away by the Panthers, and that pass out of the reach of Fleischman. Goes all the way to Brodeur, his first home game in a month. Taken away here, Upshaw for the Panthers. Able to center one, gets all the way back to the point. That shot taken by Roback, never got through, and off to the races, Ryan Carter, 3-on-2. Carter shovels one in front, Bernier at the doorstep, couldn't get a stick on it. Upshaw tries to clear it out of the zone. Puck hardly moved, and Carter sends it right back in deep. At the point, Zidlitsky, able to hold the zone. Picked up here by Gianta. Feeds Bernier, centering try for Carter, deflected away. This line that was so good in the playoffs last year reunited here in the second period. Carter, Gianta, Bernier. Here's Skilly into the Devil's zone for Florida. Knocked off his stick, back to the point. Long range shot by Kuba, blocked in front, and looking to get on the puck was Huberdeau, couldn't find it. Now gets the pass from Kulikov. Huberdeau, backhand pass in front, showing a lot of skill is the 19-year-old Jonathan Huberdeau. And an opportunity here, Drew Shore couldn't get the shot away. And it's Sestito for the Devils. Sends it in deep. Mac D'Agostini delivers a hit in the zone. Kulikov able to work it free. Quick shot by Kostopoulos and the stop made by Clemenson. Andy Green pinching it at the point. Sends it in deep. Devils have taken the shots advantage now. 10-9 in the hockey game. Peter Mueller ruffled off his stick by Sestito and sends Kostopoulos on his way. Kulikov back to defend him. Huberto in his own end gets it out to center. 6:15 to go in the middle period. Devils have taken a 2-0 lead. David Clarkson doubling the advantage a moment ago. Kicked out here by Harold. Mueller able to bust into the zone and play it in deep. Andy Green under pressure gets this to Peter Harold. Banks it off glass. Picked up here at center ice. Zajac is back playing with Clarkson and Eliash. Taken here by Santarelli. 2-on-1. Plays it across. Out in the pass, and Brodeur with the big stop.
Unbelievable. Marty's been watching a lot of this game here in the second, but when called upon, he's made two dandies. And the crowd are loving it, Steve. They're chanting his name.
They've waited for this. It's been a while.
Well, it's well deserved.
Pass by Santarelli. Able to pick up.
attack. Hannon that time. Last shift, it was Shea Weber.
Ryan Ellis with the rush. Over the line. Wrist shot through traffic and a glove save. Chad Johnson. Putting on a show here tonight. Welcome back. Time now for the game summary. And early in this one, Tyson, the Coyotes get a lift from Antoine Vermette.
Transition, turnover, top corner. That's how you draw it up in the lock.
Jared Smithson won it back for the Panthers.
Pete DeBoer's gone back to the lines that he's using Carolina now.
Smithson gets by Peter Harrells. There's plenty of time to go. 11:40 left in regulation time. Santarelli has it on a backhand. Worked it free to Quentin Howden. Kulikov takes this at the point. Dmitry Kulikov fires. Brodeur got ahead of the traffic and sticked it aside. Laktionov tries to work it out of the zone. That play picked off by Santarelli.
This game's a bit like last spring's playoffs. I mean, obviously not as exciting. It didn't have the drama. But Devils, yeah, they're the better team. But can they put the Panthers away? Nope. And you just see Florida looking like, hey, there's some hope here now.
Danger here is that the Panthers are the team that can play fast and loose here. Devils have more at stake. Kovalchuk walks in, centering try. Kovalchuk slammed hard in the boards, remains down for New Jersey. Ilya Kovalchuk is hurt. We get a stoppage in play.
Oh, no, no, no. Yeah, I didn't see it, Steve. I hope it wasn't he ran into his stick. You see that sometimes where he's playing the puck and you run into it and the stick catches you below the shoulder pads. Because it could have been a hit, but I didn't really see it. But, oh my, that's not a good sight for anyone. Not just at Ilya, but let's have a look here now. Watch the finish here. Watch his stick. Oh, no, 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 no. He lost his edge, and it looks more like he was holding his chest. But it was his shoulders that strike the boards. There you see him, just right on the crest. He just favored that all the way to the dressing room. So we don't want to guess. We wouldn't have a clue exactly what it was.
A lot of concern in the building. Crowd went silent here at Prudential Center for a few moments. And here's Zidlitsky's shot, save made by Scott Clemenson. On the Devils' 20th shot. Now Kostopoulos. There's a penalty coming up as Tim Sestito went down and Kostopoulos went to retaliate on behalf of his teammate.
Well, Robach runs Sestito into the boards. Oh, my goodness. And then he was jumped by Kostopoulos. We'll only wait to sort this out. Now, Robach is going to the bench. I wonder if it was a hit from behind where he's been thrown out of the game. We only can wait to see.
He hasn't gone down the tunnel yet. I don't know if that's concern for Sestito or...
He's definitely going to get a penalty, so he should be going to the penalty box, Steve, but we'll have to wait. Yeah, this is going to be a tough one to sort out. We'll have lots of time to do it. We'll let you know as soon as we get...
Coming up, the Foxwoods Final Five. Foxwoods, your destination for endless excitement.
Well, it's up as a boarding call, a five-minute boarding call again. Kobe Robach, and you just can't do that. And Kobe knows that. He wouldn't want it done to him. You know, Sestito skating there, ride him into the boards. But don't give that extra little push. The player's not suspecting it, and once you lose your balance, you cannot stop. And there you hear the collision, and just, I don't think the kid's a dirty player. Matter of fact, he's just getting a shot here, but he deserves the five because he pushed.
Harold with a quick shot on the power play for the Devils and a save by Scott Clemenson.
You know, like I say, Steven, players know that that's one of the most dangerous plays to throw a player off balance when he's unsuspecting, especially when he's going towards the boards and is within 4 feet of him.
Mike Santarelli is the player serving the penalty to Robach in the box. And Robach is gone from the game as Zidlitsky takes this and carries for New Jersey. Marek Zidlitsky. Eliash dishes it across, able to pick up Clarkson. Offside on the play is New Jersey. 42 seconds have elapsed in the power play. Another sellout. The 15th in 17 games this season. Crowd at Prudential Center has been the seventh man on the ice, if you will.
They've been patient tonight. The slow period, that first, but they waited, and when the Devils got it going in the second, they were ready to join them. And now they're just kind of biting their nails a little bit, hoping they'll get a little breathing room and get that power play goal.
The win on Thursday, the Devils' first on the road since February 21st. After tonight, just 16 games left. Nine of the seven will be on the road. David Clarkson plays this ahead. Puck comes out to center. Travis Ajak trying to get on the loose puck and get around Brian Campbell. He could not, and it's thrown across by Drew Shore. Fleischman back to Shore. Soft shot, stick the side by Marty Brodeur. Over 3.5 remaining in the Devils' power play. 5-minute major for boarding issued to Colby Roback. Here's Campbell. Throws one across. Fleischman able to get it behind the goal. Shore plays this back to the point. Played across by Florida. Strachan feeds this to the circle. Shot blocked away. And now Green collects for the Devils. Crowd growing impatient on the power play here at Prudential Center. Now Green able to pick up Adam Henrique, who skates it into the zone. Eliash dishes it across. Chance for David Clarkson. Bouncing puck got by Henrique at the side of the cage. Good keeping by Peter Harrell. Zitlitsky fires on a shot deflected wide. Picked up by Philip Kuba. Marcel Gotch on the loose puck for Florida. Battles forward in the corner, and Kuba is able to lift it away. Harold in front of his own net collects here for New Jersey. 2:37 to go in the Devils' power play. Henrique over the line. Played it across. Kopetsky broke that up, and Florida able to clear the zone once again. Ilya Kovalchuk has not emerged from the locker room yet. Zajac battling for the loose puck. Clarkson tried to play it ahead. Bouncing puck picked up by Salvador, who collects for New Jersey. Plays this for Loktionov. Loktionov over the line. Deflected away. On now, Loktionov holds and plays it back to the point. Gets it back from Salvador. Loktionov shoots through traffic. Clevenson's got it, and he holds on. 2:01 to go in the Devils' power play. Adam Henrique. Well, it was his biggest moment as a professional against the Florida Panthers, because the Ranger game came weeks later. He reflected on that. He said everybody's memory of him 11 months later is still the Ranger game. And the photo that even we showed in a broadcast a couple of weeks ago, that doesn't happen without his goal against Florida. And he recognizes the importance of that. Here's Travis Zajac on the power play for the Devils. Works it here for Randy Green. Zajac back to the point. Green across for Salvador. Rare to see Bryce getting power play time. The Devils utilizing him here. Here's Zajac. Plays it in front. Redirection by Bernier goes wide.
Yeah, here's a power play you're not going to see very often. Salvador, Green, D'Agostini. But I think the Devils coaches just didn't like what they saw from the first and second unit.
Here's Zajac. Tries to put one through the legs of Philip Kuba. Loose in the corner. Still 1:24 to go in the power play. Zajac able to work this back to the point. Salvador able to collect under traffic. Had it tipped away, and look out. Smithson heads for the bench. Mathias does the same.
Now coaches say be just as urgent when you got a 5-minute power play as you do when you have two. But it's human nature. Very seldom does it happen.
Henrique holds for the Devils. Tries to throw one in front. Backhand try by Clarkson. Didn't get through. Peter Harrell winds it around. Clarkson battling deep in the zone. Puck winds around. Picked up by Harrell at the point. Gives to Henrique at the half board. Clarkson's the man in front. Back to the point. Harrell lays it across. Marek Zidlitsky collects. Those two operate on the point. Here's Zidlitsky. Holding. Takes it down low. Centering try. Clarkson trying to get on it. Loose at the side of the cage. Clarkson able to backhand one towards the point. Zidlitsky's got it. Gives it to Clarkson. Trying to shake loose of Gotch. Zidlitsky shot blocked away. Picked up here by Harrell. Tries to throw a backhand in front. Wouldn't go. Taken behind the net. Eliash takes. Gives to Henrique. Throws it to Clarkson. Shot. And that one wide of the cage. Picked up by Henrique. 15 seconds to go on the power play. Eliash for Henrique. Darts behind the cage. Henrique back to the point. Harold's got it. Gives to Zidlitsky. Final seconds of the man advantage. Pass got by Eliash. Campbell fights forward in the corner. Santarelli standing up in the box, and a 5-minute kill completed for the Panthers.
And we can't forget that Ilya Kovalchuk was not available for that power play. But you know, that last group really created some nice stuff down low. And David Parks is going to be kicking himself on the bench. He had it puck all alone in front. He just ripped it, but obviously pulled it wide.
Banked out of the zone by Adam Larson. Just over 5 minutes to go in regulation time. Devils clinging to this 2-1 lead. Andy Green back in his own end. Plays it ahead. D'Agostini collects it off the boards. Had it stripped away by Drew Shore. Pass for Huberto is just out of his reach. And Volchenkov makes the touch. It's icing against Florida. You're watching the Foxwoods Final Five. Foxwoods, your destination for endless excitement.
Well, David Clarkson having a good final two periods. He got the first goal, which was very important. There he is to the left. And he just catches that, and he has the right idea. High glove. Just didn't twist his body quite enough. And she sailed wide on him. That's a great look there, guys. It tells you the frustration he's feeling right now. But he still has one and has had a real good game. He had four or five shots here in this game already. Now the Devils have to be careful about taking a penalty.
We're short two forwards right now. And with 4:43 to go, we'll step aside. 2-1. New Jersey leads.
Tonight's Move of the Game is brought to you by Optimum Moving. Take Optimum service with you. Visit Optimum.com moving to learn more. Look at this move here by David Clarkson. He toe drags it to open up the shooting lane and then will not give up on this puck. This is hunger to score goals right here, you young hockey players. When the coach says we need some hunger around that goal crease, well, there you see it right there. A beautiful optimum move of the game by David Clarkson. Right now it is the go-ahead goal. But as you mentioned, Steve, the Devils are down two forwards, and the Panthers should have some rested players on the ice.
Walking in is Howden.
Hold it. I was going to say that's 10 feet offside. Oh, it was just a late call, but I thought
they were all over it in the end.
Well, the right winger was, oh, he was inside the zone before the player with the puck even hit the blue line. And as long as they get it, you know, even if it takes a while, but we'll see how Pete DeBoer is going to change the lines now. Now, this line is still intact. Zajac, Clarkson, and Elias.
Gotch, Fleischman, Kopetsky for Florida. Off the draw, Zajac is able to push this ahead and skate it into the Florida zone. Collides with Brennan, and the puck comes to Kopetsky. Ryan Campbell plays it across. TJ Brennan ahead for Fleischman. Here's Campbell. Long-range shot and a whistler that goes wide of Brodeur's cage and banked out of the zone by New Jersey. Brennan back in his own end. Clarkson trying to win the race, and Brennan is able to make the touch. It's icing with 4:09 to go. Don't forget, after the game, Bill Pito, Billy Jaffe, Ken Danico, Dave Maloney with a breakdown of Devils Panthers and a trip around the National Hockey League. Hockey Night Live presented by Kia, coming your way after the game on MSG Plus. A big 4:09 to play here. Drew Shore takes the faceoff deep in the Devils' end. Zajac again wins an important defensive zone draw. All the way down, Clemenson has to play this is on goal, and he leaves for Filip Kubak. Picks up Kulikov, plays it ahead. Jonathan Huberto shovels one across, and we get a stoppage in play on the offside.
Well, Huberto's had a couple of chances, Steve, and he was real hot to start the season. He had, what, 12 goals in 25 games, and only a few of the great ones reached that mark after 25 goals. But since then, he's gone a little bit cold. Talked to him this morning. You know, he didn't say some of it's just the energy it takes to play at this level and be consistent. Probably other teams have had a look at him. You know how well they scout and say, you know, this is one of his power moves. Be careful when he goes into this. But he still had a couple chances tonight. Marty Brodeur robbed him at least once. That should have been a goal.
No goals in six games coming into this for Jonathan Huberto, but those 12 in the first 25. How about these names? Active players who've done it. Ovechkin, Crosby, Malkin, and Teemu Selanne. That's it. The active players in the league.
Wow.
Picked up here by Green behind the cage. Here's Ryan Carter to center. Over the line, punches it in deep. Campbell trying to collect this for Florida, battling with Bernier. Cut taken away by Mathias for Florida. Lakhdianov on the forecheck. Played across, here's Brian Campbell. Lifts it across, gloved down by Mathias, who's on the move now for the Panthers. Trying to tie the game late. Mathias shot. Brodeur got a piece of it with the glove, taken here by Henry. Tries to wind it out of the zone, could not. Kostopoulos delivers a hit, taken here again by Kostopoulos and muscles it out of the zone. At center ice, taken here by Fleischman. Gave the puck away to Salvador. Kostopoulos, blocked away by Brennan. Comes here to Zablitsky, who fires it in. Bouncing puck gets by Scott Clemenson. Off the boards, Kostopoulos deep in the zone, able to take this to New Jersey. Tries to shovel it across for Eliash, comes back to the point where Green has it and sends it in deep. Brennan, played ahead. Kopetsky across for Thomas Fleischman. Looking for Gotch. Pass got by him. Green, deep in his own zone, battles forward in the corner. Up jarred loose, taken here by Travis Ajak. Sent ahead, Clarkson able to tap it out of the zone. Steven Gionta gives chase here, and Chase is scrapping back with just over 2 minutes to go. Here's Philip Kuba. Gotch at center. Dumps in. Harold back to collect for New Jersey. Gives to Green and funnels it ahead. Gionta trying to work it out of the zone. Under some pressure, plays it back to Green. Peter Harrell, long pass, able to pick up Bernier. Steve Bernier in, got a shot away, and a glove save made by Clemenson.
Yeah, heroic lean by Bernier to get that shot off. That there's no way that Strack is not going to knock this off a stick, but look at Steve Bernier. Remember, he was a first-round pick. That's beautiful. Gets that left arm out, one hands it on to Clemenson, who had to gobble it up with his mitt. And he's not happy, but that was a terrific move by Steve Bernier. And a couple shifts left for each line here.
Eliash in deep. Just over a minute and a half to go. Eliash in the offensive zone, poked away by Brian Campbell. Mueller in the corner, gives here to Brennan, and taken by Campbell. He gives to Huberdeau. Pass across, picks up Mueller over the Devils' line. His shot, gloved by Brodeur. Tried to play the puck in time to keep it alive. Instead, face-off in the Devils' zone with 1:16 to go.
Yeah, Marty wanted to play that. You know, he's so aware of the clock and his surroundings. He knew if he could keep it going, Devils would have had a nice breakout. But now, they got to win a face-off here. And we're having a timeout by...
Florida.
Okay. Marty Brodeur, 18 shots on goal tonight. You see Kevin Dineen, I like that. Kevin, the coach sits down. Never seen that. Usually the coach is standing up, hanging over the bench. You know, Kevin was such a fiery player, but he's very calm in the way he handles things most of the time. Like every coach, he loses it here. But he's just hoping that his team could win it.
Born leader, he was captain of three different NHL teams. The Whalers, the Flyers, and the Hurricanes later on.
Well, as I mentioned, Steve, there's just a slew of young players on this Panther team. They've got young prospects coming up out of college and junior. One of their junior players won the OHL scoring. Another's a Hobie Baker candidate, as I said. So there's a bright future, and if the Panthers were stock, I would buy into them. But I think there's only one way it can go, and is up. But right now, all Marty Brodeur could think is, we need this win, and we got to shut down the Panthers here for the next minute and 16. And it starts with Zajac winning the faceoff.
Scott Clemenson on the bench. Six attackers on for Florida. Gotch is the faceoff man for the Panthers. Off the draw. This time Gotch wins it back. Trying to poke it out of the zone is Gionta, and he works it away. Collected here by Fleischman. Lays it across for Peter Mueller. Pass for Mathias, off his stick. Zablitsky sends it back the other way, and Campbell retreats with a minute to go in the third period.
See, Zablitsky knew he was on the wrong side of center ice, Steve, and he didn't just rifle it down for the open net. He chipped it along the boards.
Gotch on the move, feeds Fleischman over the line, has it knocked away. Good play by Clarkson.
Now Clarkson puts it along the snow in front of the both benches. It slowed it down enough. There's no icing.
Campbell to center. Slaps it into the devil's zone. Salvador deflects to Mueller instead for Florida. Throws one across on the loose puck. Elias backhands it out of the zone. Huberto takes this, 23 seconds to go. The Panthers rookie has the pass intercepted by Bernier. Gave it back and taken away. Kopecky, long pass out of the zone. Fleischman plays it across, gloved out of the zone. Loose at center ice, taken by Bernier. He fires towards the empty net, gloved down by Campbell. 5 seconds remaining, steered into the devil's end, and that will do it. Martin Brodeur with a 17-save performance once again, and the Devils have back-to-back wins. Hold on to beat the Panthers 2-1.
Here, Fleischman and Henrique, and it started right at the end, Steve. I'd like to see it. Bryce Salvador is hurt. Now, I don't know if it was an accidental shot or what happened on that last play. Only a couple seconds left, and I don't know if the Panther going for the puck fell and knocked Bryce down, but it caused some aggravation by the Devils. Particularly Henrique, let's see here now. There's 24, 2, 1. Oh, Upshaw, that's a bit of a late hit there. Now, in all fairness to Scott, I don't know if he didn't know that there's like a second left. But he kind of turns and bangs into the hip of Salvador. And then you see Fleischman and Henrique. Oh, Fleischman with a quick left. But he was on the ground in a hurry as the Devils continued the fight after the whistle. But good news is for them, Steve, they got the 2 points.
I saw Salvador as he went off. He appeared fine. He tapped Johan Hedberg's pads and then high-fived about five fans. Here are the game's three stars. Let's listen.
It's time to announce tonight.